Here's the rundown of some of the best in the city scene this week. A coming-of-age musical, and a comedic story of finding true love. Plus, the famous Singapore sling is now Manila sling. The countdown starts now, so get ready as we explore the cityscape. Hi guys, I'm Pamela Miranda, your guide to the urban jungle, and we're giving you a lowdown of the best in the metro. Last week, art enthusiasts were treated to a feast for the eyes as contemporary artists and galleries converged for the Art Fair Philippines in celebration of National Arts Month. Michelle Ong reports.
As part of Makati's continuous Make It Happen, Make It Makati campaign, the city partnered with Art Fair Philippines to showcase works of selected Filipino artists for display all over the city called the Urban Art Project.
Philippine art is making such waves in Southeast Asia, and we just, well, it would be great if the average Filipino would know that this is an aspect of our culture that is so vibrant, it's so exciting, and something that we should all be proud of. When we conceptualize this, we knew that the only way to make, in a sense, we wanted to make art accessible. So we wanted a venue that was different and that was accessible. And we said, there's no other place to do it but Makati, because so people can go to it. Sort of mirrors our art scene also.
I think any project is helpful. It's nice to bring Makati to the forefront of the art scene. We welcome all forms of exhibits.
To coincide with the launch of the Urban Art Project, Art Fair Philippines held an exhibit displaying artworks from 24 different galleries.
We thought that we could make it even bigger by providing all those urban art installations so that the people who work and live here will be able to enjoy these pieces of art scattered all over.
Some of the most viewed pieces in the exhibit were Gabriel Barredo's dark and eccentric art installation entitled Asphalt. While Alab Pagarigan used copper wires for his pieces, creating human figures.
While this is the first one, we're looking forward to maybe having this annually here in Makati.
Well, I think it's really a chance to support art in general. And in true Philippine fashion, it's come alive. It's fun. Everyone's happy. There's great representation from the artistic community. It's nice to bring art into Makati in different ways. This is an unusual way. I think everyone's pleasantly surprised. And it seems to be a great success. And so we're just delighted to be working with them and working with all the artists here.
The Urban Art Project gives the general public another reason to visit Makati City. And you can still view some of these world-class art pieces in key areas of the city until the end of February. If you haven't found a suitable gift to give your man, here's something you might want to consider. A gorgeous timepiece to match your gorgeous guy.
It's a nice, beautifully crafted, meticulously detailed automatic watch.
These arm candies boast of state-of-the-art technology and attention to detail that caters to the taste of the modern man.
Seven Friday, the most distinct feature is really its look, right? There are three models, the P1, P2, and P3, and they're all inspired by different types of industry.
Depending on his personal aesthetic and lifestyle, you can choose from these three models inspired by machines, engines, and art. The P1, with its classic and industrial design, would best suit a man who sticks to the classics that have withstood the test of time. While the vintage feel of P2 is for someone who appreciates details and vintage designs. And P3's edgy feel is perfect for the adventurous man who likes to live on the edge. With these timepieces, he will surely be on time, wherever, whenever.
When we return, two musical plays that are worth watching. Stay tuned, we'll be right back. Welcome back to Cityscape. Award-winning musical Spring Awakening takes center stage once again as the Ateneo Blue Repertory stages its version of this rock musical. Mama,
Mama gave me. The Ateneo Blue Repertory is closing its 21st season with a Tony Award-winning rock musical, Spring Awakening. The musical is set in a village in 1890s Germany, where the adolescents are starting to experience adult emotions and are becoming more curious about themselves for the very first time.
Blue Rep's, theme for this year is, are we there yet? And for a long time, Blue Rep has been staging shows that was sort of like, you know, your regular sort of splendid, happy musicals, and I guess this year, with the theme, Are We There Yet?, they sort of want to go to the next level of exploring material that is has a lot of weight and has a lot of relevance to today's society. For example, in the play, they tackle things like abortion, premarital sex, suicide, homosexuality, things that are still pertinent in today's society. And the play was written in 1891, and these are issues that are still prevalent, especially here in the Philippines.
The story highlights three teenagers in particular. Melchior, a free-spirited intellectual, trapped within the rigid confines of his school. His best friend, Moritz, who is struggling academically by day and haunted by sexual dreams at night. And Wendla, who is starting to discover her own sexuality and is frustrated when her mother decides to keep her in the dark about everything.
Each character has its unique problems, has its unique facets that people will relate to them no matter what. Be it about school, about, you know, curiosity, about fighting a tradition, I think people will really relate to all of them.
The rock music within the musical, paired with vigorous choreography, is tempered with both the sweet and sad numbers that showcase the teenagers' vulnerabilities. And although the play is set in the 19th century, the controversial themes tackled, like homosexuality, abortion, and premarital sex, are still hot topics even up to this day. Problems that are usually kept in the dark are discussed under a spotlight, and this is what makes Spring Awakening so intriguing to watch.
We wanted to go for a more naturalistic and a more organic feel, and to really capture the raw emotion and how people in those times would react and deal with these sentiments. Not so much in stylized staging, but in a more, I guess, organic way. I guess that's the word, organic.
Our father and mother, in what ways have we, in soul, in body,
We'll stop now before we spoil anything for those of you who aren't familiar with the story, and let these talented kids enthrall you when you see Spring Awakening at Ateneo's Rizal Mini Theater.
Here's another story of love accompanied with songs and a lot of laughter. After her stint as Elle Woods in Legally Blonde and Charity in Sweet Charity, Nikki Hill is back on stage for the restaging of They're Playing Our Song. Monica Magpantay fills us in on this comedy musical.
Valentine's Day may be over, but it's not yet too late to celebrate the season of hearts with the Nine Works theatrical restaging of the comedy musical They're Playing Our Song.
Our second to the last musical was Sweet Charity, and it was a raving success. The book, the scriptwriter of that musical is also the same scriptwriter here, Neil Simon. So one of the choices that we made, because that was a classic, and after it was received well by the audience, we sort of made it a decision that we should always revive at least one classic a year. Make it a point to share it with the audiences today who weren't able to see it back in the 70s or back in the 80s and early 90s. So we looked for another musical that's just as funny and just as entertaining, and this was top of the list.
The play takes us to the ups and downs of the love story of composer Vernon Gersch and quirky lyricist Sonia Walsk and the beautiful music they make together before finding their way to true love. Top billed by TV host and singer Nikki Hill and theater actor Lorenz Martinez, this light-hearted comedy surely delights theater fans with its witty and comical dialogues and unforgettable tunes by Tony Award-winning composer Marvin Hamslisch.
Be reminded about romance through the music. Marvin Hamslisch's songs, who doesn't know Fallen, right? And they'll probably walk away from the show humming the tunes because they're just, you know, I know that song. It's very relatable. The lyrics, it's like I'm sure you've said it once in your life. And I like to think our audiences will be able to say, yeah, I've been there, I've done that. And that's also my story.
Miss the chance to catch this well-loved musical, which runs till the 3rd of March.
The iconic Singapore Sling finds its way to Manila. That's coming right up. Don't go away. Cityscape will return in a bit.
For our next outing, we will make sure to get there in the most stylish and comfortable way possible, just like the Kia Sorento.
The new Kia Sorento is our most recent offering. It's an improved version of our Sorento that we launched in late 2009, early 2010. And as you will note, it has a different front face compared to that of our earlier model in 2010. And it also offers unique features compared to that of the one we earlier launched in 2010. So everything that you would see probably in a luxury SUV is contained in the new Sorento.
A sleeker and sexier version, this top-of-the-line model has all the bells and whistles, a nice set of wheels, a spacious cabin to comfortably sit a small family and store your things, luxurious leather seats, and a fully retractable sunroof to enjoy those countryside drives, just to name a few. But the true innovation lies within.
Sorento, no matter what variant it is, from the basic until the top of the line, it has an engine that is quite advanced, I would say. It is small, it's a 2.2-liter engine, but it delivers a very high horsepower rating. It's 2.2 liter, but it delivers 197 horsepower. One, that translates to fuel efficiency. You have a small engine, and the horsepower rating is high, so you drive at very low RPMs, so the engine is not stressed. That translates to fuel efficiency. Secondly, a smaller engine emits less emission. we are offering a CRDI, Common Rail Diesel Injection Engine, and this is the latest in diesel technology. Whereas before, people associate unclean air as far as diesel engines are concerned, but our diesel engines right now are far more advanced. They're very clean, and especially in Europe, we meet European air standards.
A smaller engine translates to more fuel savings. An important factor to consider alongside the rising fuel prices and Manila's stop-and-go traffic that burns up gas so much faster. We took the Sorrento out for a spin and were pleasantly surprised. Even the most basic variant is easy to maneuver, and the ride is very comfortable for its class. You can hardly feel the bumps on the road, and it handled itself well through curves as well as through straight roads. All the basic things you'll want or need your vehicle to do. It's a nice sturdy ride, and we have no doubt it will withstand not only the hustle and bustle of your daily lives, but make it through some heavy-duty road trips as well. All while ensuring its passenger safety and comfort.
The iconic Singapore Sling of Raffles Hotel in Singapore has landed in Manila, bringing with it a localized version. So I went to the long bar at the Raffles Hotel in Makati to try them out. Watch this. The iconic long bar at the Raffles has never had a branch outside Singapore until now. That's right, the birthplace of the famous Singapore Sling has settled down in Manila with a few surprises in tow. Let's check it out. Our country's long bar was done up in such a way as to emulate the original long bar at the Raffles Singapore, with details like the ceiling fans, the tiles on the floor, and the Charlie Chaplin movies that are shown on repeat on all screens, making it to our shores as well.
I think one of the key elements here of the long bar is that a lot of the design elements were taken over from the original. The ceiling fans, which you can see above us, the long bar, the floor, little gimmicks such as the monkey nuts, as they're called, very famous. I mean, Singapore being such a clean and restricted place, being able to throw peanuts on the floor after you eat them is something relatively revolutionary there. We took that concept, we brought it here just to add a little bit of fun to the experience. Of course, you can't forget to mention the Singapore Sling, which has been created in the long bar in Singapore, and of course has found its way on our menu as well, according with some local twists, which I think is what makes this bar very unique. Is we've been able to incorporate local elements in what we do here as well, not just copy and paste what's happening in Singapore.
As it is throughout the rest of the hotel, the long bar is covered with artworks done by local artists that show a taste of the local culture. But our favorite has to be this massive mural that depicts a bartender making a Singapore Sling while two appreciative fans look over his shoulder. And speaking of Singapore Sling, before you ask, yes, the long bar do serve it here. This heady concoction of Tanqueray with fruit juice and other secret goodies are whipped up in front of your eyes. But the real draw here is the Makati Luxury Sling, a similar drink made of all premium ingredients.
It was very, very quickly clear we needed a local element to the Singapore Sling, and that's where the idea of the Makati Luxury Sling was born. The basic ingredients are very similar to what the Singapore Sling is, but then we added our own twist to it, again, to create that luxury experience. We made our own Angostura foam, and then just sprinkled some 24 karat gold on top of the drink to really give it a little bit of a different feel and flair.
Now I'm about to try a long bar's iconic drink, which is a Singapore Sling, and the local counterpart, which is the Makati Luxury Sling, and let's see how it compares. Yes. Oh, pretty strong, but it's very refreshing. You can taste the pineapple, and it's really good. Now, for the Makati Luxury Sling. It's a bit sweeter. I think it's better suited for Filipino palate. And I love the gold flakes on top. It's a fun drink. And just like in Singapore, you can enjoy their complimentary peanut, and you can just throw the shell on the floor. Warning, it's very addicting.
And the idea generally is, of course, to create a relatively relaxed flair, but yet we do try and provide a luxury experience for our guests. So this should be a place, or what we're trying to be is a place where you can come after work, where you can come in the evening with friends or you know, colleagues and enjoy a few great cocktails, listen to some great music in a very relaxed but yet refined atmosphere.
It's the relaxed, elegant, and slightly nostalgic atmosphere that draw guests here. But I think the drinks definitely entice them to stay.
I hope you liked our episode and be sure to try out the features we just showed you. Anyway, our 30 minutes are up and I'll see you all next week as we count on only the best in the city scene. I'm Fimella Branda. Thank you for watching Cityscape.